गुड आफ्टरनून एवरीवन, आई एम प्रोफेसर बनकर डीबी, डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ केमिस्ट्री, आरबीएनबी कॉलेज श्रीरामपुर। इन प्रीवियस लेक्चर वी हैव लर्न द सिंथेसिस ऑफ कार्बोहाइड्रेट मॉलिक्यूल, दैट इज वी हैव सीन द किलियानी-फिशर सिंथेसिस। नाउ इन दिस लेक्चर वी विल सी द सेकेंड मेथड फॉर द सिंथेसिस ऑफ कार्बोहाइड्रेट, दैट इज रब डिग्रेडेशन मेथड। In case of Killian-Fisher synthesis, there is increase in carbon atom by one unit from starting material to the product. It means if we use the starting material with 5 carbon atom, then the obtained new carbohydrate molecule has 6 carbon atom. In case of RUB degradation method, there is decrease in carbon number. We will see the detail of RUB degradation method. Here we start the RUB degradation method with D-glucose molecule. This D-glucose molecule has 6 carbon atom, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. First step is oxidation. Here we use bromine water. So this is mild oxidizing agent. This bromine water do the oxidation of this D-glucose. There is formation of aldolic acid. It means CHO group undergo oxidation into the carboxylic group. So there is formation of aldolic acid. So this is aldolic acid. Then this aldolic acid is allowed to react with calcium carbonate. This calcium carbonate act as a base and it abstract the proton from carboxylic group and there is formation of salt. So this is calcium aldolate salt. Here this aldolic acid react with calcium carbonate and there is formation of calcium aldolate salt. So this plus minus charge can be stabilized by the Ca2+. In next step, this calcium aldolate salt is allowed to react with Fenton's reagent. That is H2O2 Fe2+. So this calcium aldolate salt react with Fenton's reagent H2O2 Fe2+ and there is formation of new aldehyde molecule with one carbon less. So we have this compound. This is aldopentose. This is aldopentose. We can call it as ribose. We call it as ribose. So look at this structure. This is aldohexose. This is aldohexose. This aldohexose consists of 6 carbon atom. It undergo rub degradation method, that is it undergo changes using bromine water, calcium carbonate, and finally with Fenton's reagent. Here we get new carbohydrate molecule, that is aldopentose having 5 carbon atom. It means there is decrease in carbon atom by 1 unit. So this is about rub degradation method. Consider next point. Here up to we have seen about D-glucose molecule. Here we will see about fructose. This fructose is also called as 2-ketohexose. Consider structure of this fructose. In case of carbohydrate, there is, in case of D-glucose molecule, there is presence of aldehyde group. In case of this fructose, there is presence of ketonic group. Here we can give number 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. So at second carbon atom there is presence of ketonic functional group, therefore this fructose can be also called as 2-ketohexose. So this is D-fructose molecule, we call it as also 2-ketohexose. We will confirm the presence of ketonic group into the fructose molecule by performing different reaction. So initially this fructose molecule is allowed to react with hydrogen cyanide, that is HCN, and there is formation of cyanohydrine compound. There is formation of cyanohydrine compound. This is again well-known reaction, that is addition of HCN across carbonyl group. There is formation of cyanohydrine. So this is cyanohydrine. Here there is formation of diastereomeric mixture. It means this OH can be present on right hand side or this OH can be present on left hand side due to addition of HCN, that is CN, across carbonyl group. There is creation of this chiral center. Due to presence of this chiral center, there is formation of diastereomeric mixture. In next step, this cyanohydrine undergo hydrolysis reaction using water and acid. There is hydrolysis of the CN into corresponding acid group. COH acid CH2OH we have this type of structure. This structure is called as hydroxy acid. Hydroxy acid. Then again here we have diastereomeric mixture. This hydroxy acid then allowed to react with HI is allowed to react with HI under heating condition. There is formation of acid, that is alpha methyl caproic acid. This is again chiral center. Look at structure CH3, CH, COH, CH2, CH2, CH2 and CH3. Name of this compound is alpha methyl caproic acid. So formation of alpha methyl caproic acid indicate that fructose molecule has carbonyl group at C2 position. Consider next point, that is epimer. So epimer is one of the important term generally used in the carbohydrate chemistry, that is epimers. We will consider different structures. This is D-glucose molecule. We will write it as compound first. This is D mannose. We write it as compound second. So this is structure third, that is D-galactose. Then consider next structure. This is L minus glucose molecule. We write it as fourth structure. Then we give number to this carbon atom. Carbon number 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. Carbon number 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. Then look at structure first and second, that is D-glucose and D-mannose. Basically this structure looking the same. ओनली देर इज डिफरेंस इन द स्टीरियोकेमिस्ट्री एट कार्बन नंबर सेकेंड. लुक एट कार्बन नंबर सेकेंड. हियर OH ऑन सेकेंड कार्बन इन डी ग्लूकोज इज प्रेजेंट ऑन राइट हैंड साइड, वेयर एज इन डी मैनोज दिस OH ग्रुप ऑन सेकेंड कार्बन प्रेजेंट ऑन द लेफ्ट हैंड साइड. सो दो स्ट्रक्चर इन विच देर इज डिफरेंस इन द स्टीरियोकेमिस्ट्री एट वन कार्बन एटम, स्पेसिफिकली एट दिस सेकेंड कार्बन एटम, are called as epimers. So in this case, compound first and second, first and third are diastereomers, and this D-glucose and D-mannose act as a epimers. Look at structure of D plus glucose and L minus glucose. These are the enantiomeric pairs. So this first and second act as a epimeric pairs. We will see the definition of this epimers in details. Optical isomers that are differ in configuration at only one chiral center. At only one chiral center are called as epimers of each other. Optical isomers that are differ in configuration at only one chiral center are called as epimers of each other. We have seen example of D-glucose and D-mannose, that two structure are differ in configuration at only one carbon, that is C2 carbon atom. Therefore, this pair is called as epimers of each other. The next point is conversion of aldose into its epimer. Our point is conversion of an aldose into its epimer. Means what? We can convert given aldose molecule into its epimer. We will see the reaction sequence. So this is aldohexose. We will focus on this particular chiral center, that is C2. This is C2 chiral center. Here C2OH is on right hand side. Here C2OH is on right hand side. Suppose this C2 has R configuration. In first step, we react this aldohexose with bromine water. We react this aldohexose with bromine water. There is formation of acid. There is formation of acid. That is aldonic acid. If we react this acid with pyridine, then there is formation of mixture, epimeric mixture of acid. If we react this acid with pyridine, there is formation of epimeric aldonic acid. So these are epimeric aldonic acid. Epimeric aldonic acid means what? This first acid in which OH is on right hand side, this second acid in which OH is on left hand side, that OH is of second carbon atom. Therefore, here I write epimeric aldonic acid. So this epimeric mixture can be separated by suitable method. So here we separate this epimeric mixture of aldonic acid. So this is one of the separated isomer. So this electron pair on oxygen and acid functional group react in presence of H plus and water. Like that. So there is formation of aldonolactone. There is formation of aldonolactone. Then this lactone undergo reduction with sodium mercury amalgam. So this aldonolactone undergo reduction with sodium mercury amalgam, and there is formation of carbohydrate molecule. This is also aldohexose. This is also aldohexose, but in this case C2OH is on left hand side, and that configuration of this C2 is S. Configuration of C2 is S. It means here we can convert one aldose into the second aldose, that is epimeric aldose, by performing specific reaction sequence. Here we convert this aldohexose in which C2 carbon has R configuration into new aldohexose in which that C2 carbon has S configuration. So this first aldohexose and this the final aldohexose are epimeric of each other. They having different configuration at this C2 carbon atom. In this lecture, I will stop here. In next lecture, we can see the next part of this carbohydrate chemistry. Thank you.